Oh, speakers in the house. Come up across all kinds of borders. We got some South America in the house, some Central America, some Spanish. Help us out here, because clearly we can't speak the Lovin' tongue. the songs are written about often. We thought this song's about a kid trying to follow his mother into the grave, writing a suicide note, only to discover it's a song about unconditional love. Now, how punk rock is that? Welcome to Innocence and Experience. Four peroxide Irishmen rediscovering our punk rock roots. All right, one peroxide Irishman rediscovering his punk rock roots. When we first played a club called The Ritz in this great city, another century ago, we thought of ourselves as a punk band. And you know what? In all the ways that matters, we still do.
Yeah!
Still getting into trouble for doing things different. A band of equals with an audience of equals. An audience of betters then. Still in our head. It's a punk rock band, but it's not very punk to be writing a song about your mother and like I Will Follow. But then again, how many rock and roll people have lost their mothers? It turns out dozens. Maybe what losing your mother is for rock and roll is kind of what losing your father, if I've not been around for hip hop, I don't know. But it seems to be part of it. It's part of my story, and everybody here has a story like that. Everyone has a hole in their heart that they're trying to fill with something. And some days we're all orphans, all right? And anyway, I've been trying to fill that hole left since the age of 14 when my mother, Iris, beautiful Iris, died on us. And I've been trying to fill that hole with these three extraordinary men and music and love and all kinds of shit. And these incredible three men. The Edge, Larry Mullen, Adam Clayton. Who foolishly gave me the microphone. The next song we wrote, I wrote the words to try and remember, try and conjure memories of my mother Iris, because I didn't have very many of them. But it could have been Gwenda, could have been Maureen, could have been Joe, could have been lots of other names, but I'm singing for Iris, and that's where this punk rock band is going right now. Iris? Iris? When you left me an artist, and I thank you.
Just like as we go on our way.
the next few songs, we're going to take you to where we grew up, on the north side of Dublin. We'll try not to stay in the past for too long, but I'm told if you don't visit at all, you're content to stay there forever. But I guess there's a part of everyone still on the street they grew up on. A lot of the fights I'm still in started on that street called Cedarwood Road. And a lot of the best friends from back then are still my best friends now on Cedarwood Road. So come with us, meet some friends, meet Gavin Friday, meet Googie. Friends and enemies, all useful. Come with us, Cedarwood Road.
Yeah.
write a song to impress a girl called Alison Stewart. She's here tonight, I'm still working on it. You got a face that's full of beauty. I have some scars from where I've been. You got eyes that can see right through me. They're not afraid of anything they've seen. I was told that I would feel nothing the first time. I don't know how these cuts heal, but in you I found a right. If there is a dark that you shouldn't doubt.
this is the 6 o'clock news. Three car bombs have exploded in Dublin, killing 23 people and injuring more than 100 others during rush hour. Five more people died and more than 20 hurt in the blast.
Yeah. Comfort me. Thank you.
Put your hands in the sky. New York skyline for the heartbeat.
Running away. Talking to when things go wrong, and as is well known, but I know I can tell you're a nice man. What's your name? Okay, well, I'm going to think about that over the next 2 weeks or so. I'll tell you what I will do. Will you help us with the technology? Do you know what that means? We got a little thing here. Yeah, hold on. We pretend it's your phone. We sort of switch it then. Oh, look. You've got this in your phone. And this is what makes us go. We go global now on a little technology called Meerkat. Here, stick around. Our confidence. That's why I'm scared to ask the ruler up. Okay, that's Adam Clayton, Larry Mullen, The Edge. And this is the whole reason for everything that's hanging in the roof. Every bit of technology is about us and them. There is no us, there's only them. This is Elevation, come on. Gracias, Veronica. Hope Pablo Neruda. You You are one cool customer. There you go. And the jangly bits are beautiful. Very, very beautiful. Thank you for making that effort in a blue Dublin top. Come on. So we have had, you have given us an extraordinary life, and we've met some extraordinary people along the way, and none of them more extraordinary than Nelson Mandela, whose birthday it would have been today. And it gives us a great encouragement that this giant, this moral giant, had difficulties in his love life. And he had this love that just broke his heart. And we wrote a song about it. It came second at the Oscars. Maybe even third, but in our heads, it definitely came second. It's called Ordinary Love.
Fly high in the summer sky, the rest of the green. Street knows that we're in love with defeat. place, and we see ourselves as a whole. And we see the unity and not the divisions. One planet. One human race. We are here together, and we need to live together with tolerance and respect. Our only boundaries are the way we see ourselves. The only borders, the way we see each other. We must become global citizens. Our voices are important. We give our elected officials their power, but we can take it away. Be involved. We are all time travelers, traveling together into the future. But let us make that future a place we want to visit. Be brave. Be determined. Overcome the odds. It can be done.
Have you forgotten where you come from? You're Irish, but you talk like an American. Look at ya! Peeling off those dollar bills, slapping them down, slapping them down. You got 100, 200, 300 times more than you need. He says, I can see those private planes. I can see those private planes. And it's true. I'm just off a flight in Davos, Switzerland. I'm in the lobby of the Belvedere Hotel, where a man breathes into a saxophone, and everybody stares at their cell phone, and the young boy continues to moan and groan and groan in my ear. He tells me everywhere has become America.
Hands that build
Joey Ramone from another Queens. The kings of the Queens, the Ramones. So, it seems from the very beginning, we've always had in our audience activists, and we always wanted to be that from the time we started working for Nelson Mandela when we were 19, 18 years old. We did our first anti-apartheid gig, and we know that you, all of you, who have given us a great life, we know that the thing that sets you apart is that you're working to give people who've been less lucky than us a shot at a better life. And we know that's the kind of people you are, and that's the kind of people who follow us around. So, when you support Amnesty International, you're doing it. When you join the One Campaign, you're doing it. One has 7 million members now. That's unbelievable. Red has raised $300 million now. If you're buying Red stuff, if you're a Red company, the people who sorted us out, Coca-Cola, Belvedere, Bank of America, Apple, all the Red companies, we are often on this stage to kick your ass, but tonight we kiss your ass for saving lives. We appreciate it. In fact, even if just being an American citizen makes you an AIDS activist, because you have joined in and you are winning the war against HIV/AIDS. America is leading the charge. 10 years ago, only 300,000 people on those drugs. Now there's 15 million, and it's the United States of America that is paying for a large part of those drugs. So thank you, America. And all the Red Warriors in the house, Mario Batali, Senator Coons, who fights on the Hill, Spike Jones, Oliver Jeffries, who's just doing these pictures you're about to see, and the beautiful Christy Turlington, whose organization, Every Mother Counts, is fighting for the same end. We love you. Thank you, America. This is a Paul Simon song to try and tell a little bit of the story. I love it when he just plays chords. was a time I was afraid of that flag. Now I love it. It's such a thing of pride. Irish flag. A little scary though, all this nationalism that's starting up again. Be a little scared of that. Gotta watch for that. And you know, this is an incredibly tolerant city. That's what's extraordinary about this city. What you've been through, and the richness of all the people who passed through it and through you, and that's why we love New York City. And there are times when that unity has been tested, and you know, there's people out there who don't like music, they don't like women, they don't like us and our freedom, and they will not change the way we feel. They will not give us fear, neither will the government. Because faith is the enemy of fear. There's a lot of it here in the house. And we will stay. One. This is for you, Salman Rushdie. City that welcomed you.